Hello friends, my name is Nabendu Chakravarti and I'm a digital marketer by profession. So since I consider myself to be quite strong when it comes to running ads on Facebook, so I would record a video on Facebook ads and would like whoever watches this video to learn and understand from it as to how to run one particular ad on Facebook. Obviously, Facebook has many different kinds of ads that one can run on it. But I'm going to just highlight one particular ad today because of time constraints, obviously. So this ad that I'm going to show you today is traffic ad. Basically, we have a landing page, a particular website page where we want our traffic to be directed to so that they can go to this page and they can give their information and we can get one lead. All right, so let's get started. So first of all, we need to go to the Ads Manager page on Facebook. Normally, what people do is they come to facebook.com and they kind of navigate their way through the Facebook website to get to the Ads Manager page. But I have a shortcut to it, which I usually use. So I would, what you need to do is type facebook.com/ads/manage and hit enter. It will directly take us to the Ads Manager page. I have two ad accounts, and it is visible on the screen right now. On one of the ad accounts, I have almost spent 42,718 rupees so far. So we're going to use this one only. But what we can do is go to Facebook Ads Manager first. So we click on the above three lines and we get to Ads Manager. The internet seems to be a bit slow, but that's okay. I think we can manage. When we come to this page, you will be able to see all the campaigns that I have run through Ads Manager so far. I have not got these campaigns live because these were just part of the training process. And that's why you see the status is still in draft and not active or completed. So anyway, running a new ad, we need to go to campaigns. We are already on campaigns, so we will click on create. And our option here would be traffic because we want the traffic to be taken to a new landing page. So we can click on traffic and then we will click on continue. It will bring us to the campaign setup page on Facebook. Here we need to give our campaign a name, so we can name it anything. Let's say Vishap landing page demo ad, because it's a demo. After we give our campaign a name, we can see if there is any other option to be filled. So we don't need to worry about anything else. We can click on next. We come to this new page. Here we have to give our ad set another name. So we can give Vishap traffic ad demo. We can probably give the same name, shouldn't be a problem. Where do we want to drive our traffic? We want to drive our traffic to our website. So it's already clicked, so we'll keep it that way. Daily budget, we can select a daily budget based on our ability to spend. So I'll just say 500. Schedule, start date and end date is optional. So we can start, today is 12th of March. So we can say start the ad at 8 p.m. because it will take us 10-15 more minutes to set up this ad. So we'll leave it at 8. By the time this ad will be ready, 8 p.m. will be the perfect time. So we can also set up an end date. Let's say we want to end our ad on the 14th. We'll let it run for 3 days. And we want to end it at 12 a.m. or maybe 11:05. Let's make it p.m. Okay, so now it asks for audience. So where do we want to promote our ad? So we'll select random audience. We can select some particular locations in India, or we can also select any big or broad location that we are targeting, we want to target. So here it's India is by default selected. So we'll remove that. Let's select some specific locations. So I want to target Mumbai, for example. And I also want to target Ahmedabad. And I want to target Delhi. So we'll select these three locations. What is the age group we want to target? So we can select 20 to maybe 45. All genders, we do not want to differentiate. We want to target both. Detailed targeting all demographics, interest and behavior, but we can change that too. We can target based on people's interests also. For example, if someone is interested in digital marketing, the ad will only be visible to people who have digital marketing as their interest. So we can do that also. The interesting thing is we can also target people based on the mobile devices they are using. So for example, if somebody is using iPhone, and which model of iPhone, we can select them according to the device also. And similarly, you can do that for Samsung, for any device, any mobile device that you want to target. Okay, so there is an option here which says reach people beyond your detailed targeting. We can select that because it's likely to improve our performance. So on the right hand side, you can see that it is showing us how many people we can reach in a day. For 500 rupees, so we can reach 4,700 to 14,000 people, of which 149 to 431 are going to click on the links, the website link that we are going to place on our ad, which is a healthy number. And this number changes depending on which locations we are targeting. So if we run the same ad in the US, in some top cities of US, whether it's Washington, New York, so on and so forth, the ad is going to be very expensive. So for 500 rupees, we're not going to get 149 to 431 link clicks. I think the link click will drop down to 30 or 40 because the US is considered to be an expensive place to run ads. So because it's India, it's a little bit cheaper here. Okay, we can select automatic placements. It means the ad will be visible on to Facebook, Instagram, and various other locations on Facebook also where we want our ad to be visible. But we can also select manual placement, and we can select where we want to show our ad to. So if somebody has a target audience, majority of the target audience on Facebook, so I think then they can uncheck Instagram. And within Facebook also, you can select where you want to show your ads to. If you can see here, feed, stories, in-stream, there are multiple options. We can choose where we want to show it. So we'll leave it at automatic placement for now. Once we do that, our optimization ad delivery is link clicks. We can leave it at link clicks. Landing page views, we don't want. We want link clicks. All right. So we'll go to the next page now. Here it's asking an ad name. We can just say Vishap demo ad. Facebook page, you have to select a Facebook page. If you have three, four pages and you select the dropdown, the pages will appear. So I do not have a page for Vishap right now. So I'll just select a page that I created a few days ago as part of my training process. So let's select that. And you also have an option to connect the Instagram account if you are running the ad on Instagram simultaneously. And if the account is connected, it will show up here. All right, so I do not have any Instagram account connected. I think I have the other one. If I select this one, maybe it will. No, I don't. I don't really have an Instagram account connected. And it's easy to connect. Here you have an option. And if you just go on to this option, the Instagram account will be visible. All right, so what kind of image we want to use? We want to use image, video, carousel. We have the option to choose that. So let's stick to a single image for now. So to do that, we'll come down and here there is an add media option. We will click on add image. And I already have some images here that I had uploaded as part of the earlier experience on Facebook. So we're just going to take one image from here. Let's select this one. Obviously, it's not related to Vishab, but I'll just select it just to showcase you how the whole thing works. All right. So when you select the image, it's going to show you how the image will appear. If it's a square ad, it will show like this. Vertical, it will show like this. Horizontal, it will show like this. So whichever area of Facebook the ad will appear at, the image is going to show differently based on the area it's appearing to at. So anyway, once you do that, you select, click on done. And now if you can see, the images are visible here also. You know how it's going to show when the ad is actually run. So we have the image, we have the headline option. This is how it's going to appear on stories, etc. So whatever you type here, it will it will be visible on the image. If you see on top, it's going to be visible. It's the primary text. So this is a demo ad. I'm not going to promote anything. Just write this is a demo ad. We can also write headline. Click on the link below. Obviously, we're not going to type that when we actually run the ad. Our headline is going to be more catchy and more clickbaitish, because whenever we have a link that generates or a headline that generates some curiosity in the minds of people, then it's more likely that people are going to click on that link. It increases the chances of the link being clicked. Description will appear just under headline. If we put anything as description, if you can see, it's started to appear on the image also. So we're just going to put click the link and learn more about real estate. Now it's obviously just a random description. Destination is a website. We'll leave it at that. Now the important part is they're going to ask us a link or a website landing page where we want the traffic to go to. So I'm just going to select Vishab's landing page and put it here. Okay, once I do that, it's going to ask for a call to action, which is also called CTA. CTA is basically is the call to action just on the right side of the headline. If you can see here, it says learn more. We can also select book now, contact us. Whichever we feel is the right CTA for the particular type of ad, we can select that. But here we're just going to select contact us. Okay. And once we do that, we don't have to select anything else. We will click on publish and our ad will be published and we are ready to go. Okay, so that's it. That's how an ad is run on Facebook, which is a traffic ad. When it comes to running a lead ad, where there is an integrated form within Facebook that will pop up and show up to the customer, we have a slightly different options that we need to select. So we're going to just restrict it to traffic ad today. So thank you so much for your time and for watching this. I hope you've learned something from it.